Yeah? Everything's okay?
I have to kill one of them in a frying pan.
You're a fucking idiot. You know that, right?
Yeah, all good.
Okay, good.
Hey, what are you doing in the pod?
Yeah, no, he's down here.
Holy shit, that's so crazy. He's alive?
Yeah.
Wait, is it a dude?
Well, I think, Jesus, they're shaved bald before they go in. I can never tell.
Me neither.
Sorry. One assumes.
Did you find any food?
Well, you go have a look. I'm going to stay down here and, deal with this situation.
Is he there infected?
I don't think so. He looks pretty tame.
Alrighty, dude. Chat if you need me.
Alright, cool. Well, that's over anyway. So, what's your name? You want a saltine? No? Alright. Just out of curiosity. How many years did you pay for? Oh. For your little cryogenic box upstairs. 5. Oh my god, you're a fucking idiot. 5 years. You thought this was gonna be over in 5 years. Jesus fucking Christ. I mean, maybe you're not an idiot. Maybe you're just optimistic. Oh man. Ow, what? Surprise! We're still fucking out here. You're really lucky I even found you, because I wasn't even going to come into this basement. Right when we walked in, a whole bunch of them appeared. I just ran down in the basement because I thought maybe I'll get a couple goodies before we get out of here. I saw you at the bottom of the stairs and I thought, yeah, they look fresh. They look fresh. Plus we, you know, seen your box upstairs. And we just assumed that you were dead. Or worse. But look. You're alive. Welcome. Hope it's all that you hoped it would be. Who that? Just Todd. Yeah. He's, I don't know, he has this weird obsession. He really likes to collect buttons. I don't fucking know. I've never asked him. I don't really care, to be honest. Everyone's got their own thing. Who, me and Todd? Yeah, no, fuck that. For a number of reasons. First of all, I've learned it's better not to form any attachments. And second of all, I'm a deeply homosexual individual. I mean, if you couldn't tell from the, I don't know, everything about me. God damn, everyone used to care about shit like that. I used to get so stressed if I had a first date with someone and... Jesus Christ, Todd. You wanna wait the whole fucking neighborhood? I used to get really stressed if I was on a date and I was like, oh, really doesn't like me, like, texting all my friends, but... I can't even tell you the last time I thought about a girl. Or I even saw, like... Anyway. There's no point lamenting about boobs gone past. Oh, fuck yeah, you are bleeding, aren't you? Alright, hold on. I got my first aid kit here. I'm just gonna take a look at you. Alright, here. Old reliable, as I call her. Yeah, look, I don't have any stitches in here, so I'm gonna do my best, but... Who knows, maybe it'll kill you. Wouldn't that be so fucking ironic? Like, you survive the first 5 years of the zombie apocalypse in your little space pod thing, and then you die because you tripped down the stairs and bumped your head. Alright, I got... fucking rag. Alright, so... Look, close your eyes, because, you know... I'm not a doctor, Jim. Or wait, I'm only a doctor? Fuck it, I don't know. Alright, here we go. Yeah, it's not looking great. Okay, hold on, I'm gonna hold that there. Okay, hold that there to stop the bleeding, give me 1 second. I know I've got something in here. Ah, here we go. Alcohol. Not the fun kind. Wait, are you serious? Holy fuck. Hold up, where? Jesus fucking Christ, hold that thought. Telling me to come into this fucking house. I haven't found beer in so long. Like, I feel like when this all started happening, everyone just like drank all their booze, and so no one had any in their stash. But you got beer. Hold on, I gotta open this. Celebration. Oh, listen to that. Like music to my ears. Probably should have dusted it off first, but it'll do the trick. Anyway, where was I? Oh, right. Your super fucked up face. Right, okay, so. Just gonna. Thanks for holding that. Get some on here. Alright, this is gonna hurt like a motherfucker, so just, I don't know. Try not to scream, you might attract a zombie. Okay, here. Yeah, sorry. Look. It's better than your face rotting off, I suppose. Okay. Yeah. Look, got some antibiotic gel here. I'm not sterile, but, fuck it, it's antibiotics. Probably not gonna get infected. Let's see. Okay. Yeah. There you go. What else? Oh, I wish I could put a little bandage on it. You know, you should be thankful I'm using this on you. Last week, Todd stepped on a nail and I just told him, you know, pray on it. The worst part is he did. Alright, here we go. Just pop that there. Yeah, can you hold that there? Cool, you hold that. And I'm just gonna get some tape. Honestly, like, one of the the things you realize is that we used to get so freaking precious about the stupidest shit before. There you go. Oh, fuck. Hold on. Okay, there we go. Great, okay. Like, I remember any time I used to get, like, the tiniest little scratch, I'd be, like, putting fucking Neosporin and all manner of shit on it, and now it's like, did my arm fall off? No. I'm good to go. Probably should take one of these. It's an antibiotic, I think. I don't know. I found them at a drugstore, and better than taking nothing. Here. You want some beer to wash it down? Get your own fucking beer. Mm. Wow. That's fucking good. You probably should wear some clothes. It is quite cold down here. I found some upstairs. I'm assuming they're yours. Yeah? Okay, cool. Look, I found this shirt. Do you want this? Yeah, here you go. And, yeah, honestly, I was just gonna take them for me. I don't even know if they'd fit me or Todd. So, I guess you can have them back. Here. And, you're definitely gonna want these. I remember reading once in high school, they said that in Vietnam, like when the Americans went to Vietnam and fought that fucking war, that the one thing the soldiers really missed was dry socks. I get that now. Sometimes you just want some dry feet. Socks. And, shoes. Enjoy. For me? No. No, no, no. I did not grow up around here. Well, like, what's the last thing you remember? Like, what is, when did you go under? September 2020. Fuck, man, that was a long time ago. All right, September 2020. Okay, so in September 2020, I lived with my parents, no, nowhere this nice. It was like, it was not like this. And my home life, I would have liked a home life that would have been more, supportive. My parents didn't like me very much, so let's just say that when they turned, I didn't lose much sleep over it. Yeah, so. Anyway, in the beginning, I went with a group of people that I had found, and we all got in a big, I don't know, I guess you'd call it an RV. It was like, there was like 16 of us living in it. No. Todd was not one of them. And, we lived in this RV for a while, but did you know gasoline expires? Yeah. I did not either until it did. And then we, kind of just went our separate ways then. Yeah. So I kind of, I got a bike. I know, yeah, it's surprising that the apocalypse would be one on bicycles. So I got a bike, and I just kind of started going where I could find food, where I could find somewhere to sleep, and look, I mean, it's not perfect, but I'm alive. Can't say the same about most people that I know. It's kind of weird, you know, like, I miss fruit. Like pineapple. You remember pineapple? That way it would like hurt your mouth. What was that about? Who'd want to fucking eat that? I miss it though. Oh, you did not have one last week. You had one in September 2020. Yeah. Oh, speaking of. Somewhere around here, I have vitamins. You should probably take one. The food these days can be lacking. Here. Enjoy. Yeah, you know, there's a lot you're gonna have to get used to. It's okay if you don't know how to fight. I don't know how to fight. I don't know. I guess I let instinct take over. Plus I found Todd and he has an uncanny ability for finding their weak spot. Like, let's say one of them comes at him and when the guy was live, he had, I don't know, an arthritic knee. Todd just gets that knee in one hit. And I just stand behind and wait till it's over. Ah, oh, fuck. I'll tell you one thing you never get used to, though. It's this sound. You probably never heard it living around here, but a very specific sound that teeth make when they bite into someone who's still alive. You're cold here. Do you have my jacket? You know, I just, it's a fucking trip talking to someone who hasn't been around since September 2020. What did you miss? Fuck, man. Well, the government fell, after the election, things just kind of went downhill from there. Who won? Look around you. Want to take a guess? Yeah, and then by February, that's when it kind of hit big time, you know? And things went pretty quickly after that. Elon Musk made it to Mars. Yeah, here he's doing really well, actually. Yeah. Did you ever wonder what it was going to be like when you woke up? Like, what did you hope was going to happen? Mm. Yeah, that would have been cool. Alas, no. So you live here like all by yourself? I mean, it's a really nice house. Oh. Sorry. I didn't realize. I just assumed, I guess. Because there's only one pod. So, yeah, it's so weird. I always thought that I'd always want to just be alone. Like, growing up, I mean, I thought, I'm never going to get married. I'm just going to ride my Harley into the sunset by myself. And then I don't know, about, I mean, I guess it was like 2 years ago. I went to raid this one house. before Todd, it was just me. It was kind of like this one, you know, it had like the main floor and then the basement, and you'll learn this fast, but when you break into these places, you try and hit them as fast as you can, because you never know when someone might pop up, and I don't know, and so anyway, I went into this house, and you avoid the fridge, let's just state that from the outset, because those things haven't been touched in years, and whatever's in there is going to make you sick. So I'm in this house. Check the pantries. Nothing there. But it's a big house. A nice house, so I assume, you know, they must have something. So I go to the basement. And downstairs, I'm looking through the stuff, and I saw this blanket in the corner. At first I was like, you know, oh, it's just a blanket someone threw in a corner, but I knew that wasn't it, so I went over to it, and I lifted up part of the blanket, and it was this little girl. I mean, she must have been like 5 or 6, I don't know, but she'd only been there like maybe a day, and pressed up against her chest. She pulled the blanket right over her head so the monsters wouldn't get her. I just kept thinking, if I'd gotten there a day sooner. Just a day. So, when I found you alive. Hey, I'll count that as a win. Fuck. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Can you tell I haven't had a beer in like 5 years? Anyway, I think you should probably hang out with me and Todd for a while. It fucking sucks right now, you know, like, life sucks. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for you. I'm not gonna say that everything is fine, that everyone is doing great. We're not. But if you could find the people, you'll make it a little bit better. Even if, you know, they're not around forever. Like that loud motherfucker upstairs.